Hi, in this video we are going to learn how to use the stream multiplex tab. Let's add some video files. In this case I've got these ones. And here we have all the streams available for every file. If I add just one file, automatically I will see here all the tracks available. We see a video track, an audio track, and two subtitle tracks in different background colors. I can remove any of them. I can change the item language, or for example, save individual tracks like the audio track. I can also add a new, for example, subtitle track. In this case, let's imagine it is an English subtitle. And we would just go here and mux all, selecting the appropriate output format. By default, all the streams are string copied. But sometimes we need to change and re-encode any of the streams. For example, if we need our audio track to be of certain format for compatibility issues, just like some TVs with AC3 audio capabilities, we can change the encoding parameters here, add some audio bitrate information, and then we would copy everything and the other track will be converted. It will be added in this output default path, but we can also change it. And let's go for it. As usual, we will obtain the average bitrate of the output file, the playback multiplier speed, and also an estimation of the output file size. It will take about 2 minutes to go, and we will obtain the same file with a new subtitle track and just the audio re-encoded. We can only add one video track at a time, so we would need to remove that one and then add a new one. We can remove anything and, for example, save this track, this video track only, or start over and save the audio track only, string copy as the detected format, for example, AAC. This is usually a very fast process. And there we go. And this is it. Thank you very much.